our dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode Sweet 16 of the Nerd Dice Creating a RubyGem series. And like many 16-year-olds, we are in trouble with the law. So if I go and run RuboCop here, we've got 50 offenses here. 30 are auto-correctable. A lot of them are just spacing around hashes and stuff like that. So we'll do that. And we'll just do RuboCop-A. So down to 4 offenses detected. Let's see. So it's all in that refresh seed spec. Looks like it was all hash related. So it says that we've got still 4 autocorrectable offenses, but it didn't autocorrect them. So we'll take a look at what we've got now. And most of these are going to be due to the RSpec multiple expectations being an issue here. So we're going to try to refactor some of this out into a spec support directory and use a module. And then we'll also try to use some shared examples to get rid of repeated code. So all right. So we're gonna take a look at our refresh seed spec, and you can see there's a lot of repeated setup and stuff like this. So we're gonna try to refactor this out. So in our spec directory, we're going to create a new folder called support. And in that support directory, we will create a file called refresh seed helper RB. And this will just be a Ruby module, so we'll throw in the frozen string literal. So now we've got a module, and then we've got a bunch of kind of items here that we just have literals here. So we're gonna make those some constants in the seed helper here. start with random scene new And those will be our items here. So random rand original, and then we'll just these. Are mostly just arbitrary items here, but having them as constants is better than having them as literals. And then we also have there, and then we can go in and getting first seed. Okay. So we can actually get rid of this first seed variable altogether. Do the same thing here. See if we're still passing here. We have to require it. This will be see if we're still passing right now. I made a mistake here. Uninitialized constant. Original random object seed. I need to include those. So in here, after we require, we need to should help us out. We're still dealing with an uninitialized constant. Maybe if I do this, which having a name so long would kind of defeat the purpose of having a constant. That fixes things. It does, which means I want to get back to that situation where I had first value, first seed, because that is less verbose. In both those places. All right, so I'll pause and continue that pattern. So we've got the hard-coded values replaced now. We'll see how things are looking. They are passing. But this does not really provide us with much improvement. RuboCop is still angry with us. So let's see what else we can do. So in, we had initially not kind of said we were going to have a shared example for the refresh seed method, and I think we can do that now. So we'll create a file in shared examples called this is our simple example here. Make sure that we So that's what we had before. And I think I'm going to move the inclusion and requirement of the spec helper into this class. See if that keeps stuff from breaking. We're still not breaking there, so that's good. So here we've got a bunch of different kinds of scenarios here that we can, instead of having multiple expectations in each it statement, we can kind of refactor out our it statements into shared examples. So, for example, this can be it has the seed set to 0. So that's pretty much all we have for in common for that, but that is a situation that is shared by all of them. Another example would be go back to our refresh seed here. Return value to be nil. These aren't being called yet, so it won't change the effects of the specs, but we'll pause again and I'll kind of refactor out these things into a bunch of different things, and then we'll work on setting these up so that they can be called. So actually I'm gonna I think this is going to stay. The question is, is it better to have this seed reset to zero more than once, or to have this a properly refreshed seed repeated? Well, here. Not have and will be a little bit more . We've got this. Now we want to be able to, before we go any further, I want to see if I can extract this out into an it behaves like block inside of another if. So just do describe and do, and we should be able to do 16. Don't think those will run yet, or they'll fail. So we're getting some failures. Undefined method. Okay, so it's because we're not passing anything in the. So if we see here, we're not actually adding those return values yet, and that would be a good option to send back to our support module. So we'll start by creating a method here, and I've probably wasted my time doing all that replacing of things in the body of that method, but you live and you learn. So call this configure example. And I actually like the name setup example better. And we need the So in this method, we're going to set the to configure it. That'll be our setup, and then the other thing we want to do is execute the example with the config. In this case, we can take the again, the randomization technique, the argument options, and the expected return. And so the first thing we're going to do is set up the example with the randomization technique. That if might not be needed then. But anyway, we will then so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to initialize the random rand prior seed. Nil, and then we're going to look at the expected return. In these cases, we're going to just take them take the values from those keys. And then we need to going to set that if there is one and do the same thing with that gives us the prior seeds if we had them, and then if arg options. We also need to do that. That should now give us, I think, what we need for our expected return and our actual return. We're getting fussed at here. Method is too long. Deal with that later. All right, so now we should be able to go back to our properly refreshed seed and nil return technique. So I think I can do something like this in this block. So in this case, it's going to be secure random nil nil. Probably a better way to do this, but let's at least get it executing. And then in our the refresh seed method, so I should be able to just do a before hook here. And again, we can make this better. Every time. All right, so let's look specifically at our args here at this describe block, line 9. See how this is working. Ooh. Return value. We need to make that. Value. So we need to replace that with actual return. Try it again. So that's working. Although 9 might be in it. The wrong place now. Let me just run the whole. So 57 there. Ran the whole thing, the entire suite. That isolates what we were looking for. So now we can do the same thing, hopefully, for one that has a non-nil return value. So get rid of this, or we'll at least exit for now. So this is random rand. So in this case, rand this time we are expecting a return value. See how that works. Go line 24. Ooh, we got, you know, because I need to change it to be a not nil. Let me make sure I actually get that. Got that, and then we also need to make so count since refresh, last refresh we still want, and then we want the value to be not nil, and we want to have returns the expected value. In this case, we want it to equal expected return. And since one of the reasons why I put not nil there is so that we don't accidentally have a fake passing spec that actually doesn't do anything. All right, so it has. Does not have a. So I forgot to save the third scenario there. All right, so that's working. Ooh. Return value. Let's name that spec properly. There we go. Now, we've got that taken care of. We can do an exit on that. And this is the random object situation. So this will be this. proceed. See if that works. What line was that? 46. Oh, I have a mistake here. So, because I didn't update the prior, the argument there. So, random object. Prior seed. And we're making the same expectations. It's working. The overall spec is working. So we've got these items here that we've got marked out with X in. Going to get rid of. We've got them in source control if we ever need to get them back. Random rand we had. Random object. And then this is the randomize technique. Question is whether I can just so these shared examples look like something that will be able to be themselves potentially refactored back out into the helper method. So we've got random rand prior seed. Need both. Somehow they both became andum instead of random. So let's try 46. The new 46. 45. All right, so that is working, and I also want to have, since we've got this constant, there may be an opportunity to refactor this even more, but randomized, and that ends that context. And get rid of that exit. And now in our new other contexts, we will just have those combinations. And this time we've got a seed argument supplied. So we'll adapt these. So first one we have there's secure random. So in this case, we're just adding this random secure random seed here as the second argument. That's a hash. This is the new seed. So it's okay, random ran seed. Object. So this will be random object. We lost randomized somewhere along the line. So we'll not name, finish the block with a Ned. And randomized, we somehow left out. Argument for the random object. Well, very similar to this. But it will be this case. We'll have both objects specified here. So we'll have a hash with random object seed and a random rand seed. See how that whole describe block does. I've got an unexpected thing going on here. Extra comma. Let's check out. We need to turn that back into an options argument. So we can go back to our helper. I should be able to just double splat it. Let's see if that helps us. There. That's got us back. Now I want to also, since we're supplying a seed here, we've got these items in the refresh seed handler. So I'm going to add some new shared examples here for specified random object seed, and so in this case, we want describe class dot seed to equal. In this case, it's going to be the Let me see in Nerd Dice whether we have that as a... accessor. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, count since last refresh is the only one that's an accessor. So new random object seed. And we can get this working. We'll stop here and pick up the rest of the refactoring in the next video. So let me make sure that the random object with specified with no arguments okay, this is our situation with tell me I no. Okay. So in this case we want with seed arguments supplied. So this is going to behave like seed. This one, like a specified random object seed. And then this one will have both behaviors. And that looks like it's working. Randomized has both of them. Random object, random rand. So that looks like it's working. We'll stop here and pick up in the next video.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.